The Lies of the Temple, Part 56. I'm Professor Hannes Redlinghuis of the First Assembly of Yahushua in South Africa, Pretoria, Montana, also international. Should you require any of the books which I've written or have a question, just contact us at our WhatsApp number, international 20 code 2727, and the number is 0722 367 124, or just go to my website https://yahvah.co.za. If this is the first time that you are participating in the study, I urge you to go to part one. You are very, very welcome. Let me just say it, you're very welcome. But please go to part one and start from there, because you have missed quite a bit of information. It's also very necessary to subscribe to the link in order to get the different notifications of all the other studies that we are currently busy with as well. You need at least a 1611 King James Bible, a writing pad and a pen. Welcome to Breakfast with Prof Hannes. I trust that this study is going to be a blessing unto you. We will continue where we left off last week, Matthew chapter 25. We're still busy with Matthew 25. And we notice it was where Yahushua came from the temple, sat down with his disciples, who were all Hebrew men, Israelis. And he told them, and they asked him, tell us about the end time, how it should be. And he told them. And then we went over to the 10 virgins, which was the same conversation while he was sitting on Mount Olive. And in the same breath, he continued about the parables of the talents. He says in verse 14, for the kingdom of heaven is eternal life, is eternity, which to us is the most important part of our lives, is to have part in the kingdom of heaven. Kingdom of heaven, if we die, life doesn't end here. There's a lot of churches, like the Jehovah Witnesses and some of the other churches, they believe we just stay on earth, we're not going anywhere, there's no heaven, we won't ascend into heaven, we're just going to stay here. Well, the kingdom of heaven, Yahushua told us and taught us that he ascended into heaven. He says, in the house of my father there are many mansions. If it wasn't like that, I would have told you so. So I'm going to prepare you a place. If I'm finished, I'm coming back to have you where I am. Hallelujah. Where is it? In the house of the many mansions. So for the kingdom of heaven is as a man traveling into a far country. Now, we find in the word of Yahweh, all the time when Yahushua was speaking to the Jews and the Israelites, he was using parables. Why? Because they were not as educated as the people today. But even the parables that he used 2,000 years ago is relevant in the time where we are living in today, in this 21st century. He said, the kingdom of heaven is like a man traveling into a far country who called his own servants. They knew him. He called his servants, his people. Why does it say they called his own servants? Or called his own servants and delivered unto them his goods. He's going to travel into a far country. And now he's going to deliver whatever he accumulated. He's going to deliver to the people that he trusts. The kingdom of heaven is like a man. Now, immediately I understand, according to the scriptures and the teachings of Yahushua, that he came to deliver the message of salvation through the revelation blood. Actually, his revelation blood. For the atonement of our sins. Is that wonderful? He came from heaven with a purpose. And that is to offer eternal life to the Gentiles. First, his ministry was 3 years. first 2 years were only to Israel, he says, my people. And then he start, in the final year of his ministry, he start ministering to the Gentiles, which was the Samaritan woman, and then afterwards all the others. So today, in this 21st century, we as Gentiles, we were Gentiles, we are not Gentiles today. Why? Because we are Yafist, we're part of the bride of Yahushua, born again out of water and spirit, like Yahushua told Nicodemus. You need to be born again from water and the Ruach HaKodesh, the spirit. I'm so excited that we are born again. So he called his own servants. Why would it say his own servants? Why didn't he just say his servants? His own servants. Yahushua comes, he says, my people knows my name. He says, my people shall know my name. Isaiah 56 verse, I think it's 4 verse 6. He says, my people shall know my name. So he says, he's the shepherd. Yahushua is the shepherd. We are the sheep. He says, he doesn't drive us. He walks in front and his sheep will follow. Why? Because his sheep will know his voice. So what happens here? His own servants. He gave everything to his own servants. What have Yahushua done? Through grace. He has empowered us as part of his bride with authority, with a purpose, with a mission. What did he do? He gave us authority. He said, what I have done before he ascended into heaven, what I have done, I'm giving unto you. And you shall even do more. Go cast out devils, lay your hands upon the sick, and they shall be healed. So his own servants knew whatever he wanted. And we as the bride of Yahushua, we know according to the word of Yahweh exactly what Yahushua expects of every one of us. He delivered unto them all his goods. He delivered everything. What has he done? He's given everything in our hands. That's why the scripture says we are kings, sons, and priests of Yahweh. Why? Because we sat on thrones. Here, today, I'm not sitting on the throne. I'm sitting on a chair. But in the authority of Yahushua, I'm sitting in a spiritual throne of power where Father Yahweh has provided it through the blood of Yahushua, the atonement of the blood. That now we sit in a position as kings, sons, and priests. We are not beggars. The Bible says we are heirs of the throne. We're heirs of everything that Yahushua obtained. We are heirs of. That's why Galatians 3, 26, 29 says, those who were immersed in the name of Yahushua to the remission of their sins, they clothed themselves with Yahushua. We put on the wedding garment. He says, no more Jew, nor Gentile, nor Greek, nor free men, man, nor woman. And we are all one according to the promises of Father Abram. What Yahweh, our Elohim, has promised Father Abram, we are heirs of. And unto, it says here, verse 15, and to one he gave 5 talents. To another 2, and to another 1, to every man according to his several abilities, and straightway took his journey. So he hasn't given everyone exactly the same talent. And that's why Yahushua says we as part of the bride are in the body. This is what's wonderful about it. We are in the body of Yahweh, our Father, our Elohim. Yahushua is the head. He says he's the head. And we are part of the limbs. We are part of the body. The one might be the eye, Yahushua is the head, the King of Kings, and the Master of all masters, hallelujah. But somewhere in this body, we are fitting in. We've become active. When we got saved, Father Yaffa through the Ruach HaKodesh has activated us somewhere in the body. The whole body is not I. The whole body is not just arm. Or the whole body is not just feet. We are somewhere in the body where from we need to function. And I might not like the position where he has planted me, but that's who I am. If I'm the feet, one of the two feet, then I need to be the best of the two feet. Then he that had received the five talents went and traded with the same. He went, took the five talents and he started working with it and made them another five talents. I like it because I've been in business for most of my life, 43 years or something. I was a businessman and I was a pastor. Also being in the eschatology, studying the word all my life, 56 years of my life. I like somebody that can use his talent in different ways. So he's given the one guy five talents. This person, he was excited about it. And we need to be excited about what Yaffa has delegated unto us. Five talents. And he made another five talents. That's a guy that knows how to operate. And in the body of Yahushua, if we have discovered our position, doesn't matter where in the body, doesn't matter where in the body, if only we discovered our position where Yaffa has placed us, then we can function in that position. You see, the problem with most of the Christians, if I may use the word Christians, and the Christian world and the Christian church, Protestantism, is people has never discovered their position in Yahushua. After 20, 30 years in serving the Master, Yahushua, they have never found their position. They are like wandering clouds, pushing forward by different winds. He says, and likewise, he that received two talents, he also gathered unto two. Yes, you know what? He has done just as good as a guy that had five talents. He doubled what was ever delegated to him. That's somebody that can operate. You see, and all we need to do is we need to function in the Ruach HaKodesh. We need to function in the position where Yaffa places us. Whether I have two talents or five talents, as long as I operate, as long as I'm busy. Busy means working in the kingdom. We are not working for a place in heaven. We are not earning our position in heaven. No, we are saved by grace. The Bible says, the works and the deeds doesn't save us. We are saved by grace, by the blood, the redemption blood of Yahushua. We are saved by the blood. And likewise, he that had received two, he also gathered unto another two. But he that hath received one talent went and digged it in the earth, and he did his Lord's money, or his master's money. Because that Lord is with a small L, means master. He was afraid. But you see, it's easy to say that he was afraid. He might lose the one talent. You know what? The master wouldn't have given him one talent if the master didn't trust him with one talent. And a lot of time in the spiritual world, we use our inabilities to hide away. I'm sure this guy could have done something with the money, with the one talent. But he preferred to be lazy. He preferred not to be active. It's easy just to sit on my chair and just look at the sun every day, like waiting for something to happen. Nothing happens by itself. It's like us in South Africa, there's plenty of farmers, big crops. So what happens? You need to get on the tractor and you need to start plowing. You need to work. As a farmer, you can't sit under the tree the whole winter and then summer you expect a crop. There's no crop. And this is what happened here. But he that received one went and dig in the earth. He hid his talent. After a long time, the master of the house, whose servants cometh, and reckoned with them. So he came back after a time, and he need to have a response of that what was delegated to them. Now Yafa is giving us chance in life. He's given us talent in life to do what? To be active in his kingdom. Doing what? Winning souls for the kingdom of Yahushua. Now time is caught up with us. We will, if it's Yahushua's will, tomorrow morning, we are going to continue. Maranatha. Yahushua's coming. Hallelujah.